Hundreds of people were displaced when Lake Albert swelled in 2020. The sub-counties of Butiaba, Butiaba Town Council, Wanseko Town Council, Bulisa and Chigwera were badly affected. The former Prime Minister Ruhakana Rugunda and the current Prime Minister Robinah Nabbanja carried out an inspection of the mostly affected landing sites before the Office of the Prime Minister delivered relief aid to the displaced people and promised government's intervention. A report was released, but since then, nothing much has been delivered. The communities that largely depend on fishing are appealing for the promise to be fulfilled.
After being registered, let them follow those people who are the pups of the flood to come in and help them.
Request as the indigenous community of this place, we are requesting government to come and listen by for us land so that they relocate us somewhere so that we leave this land in peace.
Commercial and residential houses were swept away by the floods, leaving owners homeless. Over 2,000 people were registered to receive compensation by the OPM, but only food was delivered.
We have never received any assistance from government unless they only give us 4 kilograms of bottle and 4 cups of beans.
I had 4 houses worth 20 million shillings that were washed away by floods. The MP of Bulisa, Stephen Birahwa, brought the former Prime Minister Ruhakana Rugunda, who promised us iron sheets and food, among other items. But he went before fulfilling anything. Then Nabbanja came and we were asked to collect 10,000 shillings for registration. But nothing has ever been delivered. Kabagambe Kamanda, the LC3 chairperson for Bulisa sub-county, reveals that even public facilities like schools, health centers, markets and the immigration office at Wanseko were all affected by the floods. He now wants physical planning to be carried out in all landing sites as a preventive measure.
Planning for this landing site so that we see how organized people can start a new construction and start a new arrangement of the settlement.
Billy Rothungeyo, the medical officer from the Minority Rights Group International, has appealed to government to at least relocate the flood victims to a safer place.
We at Minority Rights Group, we want government to create that balance. Yes, you're doing your mandate, but also don't forget about the people.
He says the people of the shores of Lake Albert should also get alternative ways of survival apart from fishing. When the floods occurred, the Bulisa District authorities petitioned the Office of the Prime Minister for help. Report compiled by Godfrey Mohomoza for the news.